हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर पीसी कंबोडिया, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश, बीएसआर, गवर्नमेंट आर्ट्स कॉलेज, अलवर, राजस्थान. दिस वीडियो इज़ फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ बीए पार्ट सेकंड इंग्लिश लिटरेचर पेपर सेकंड. इन दिस वीडियो वी डिस्कस चैप्टर फिफ्थ सेक्शन सेकंड ऑफ द नोवल इनसाइड द हवेली. In the very beginning of this chapter, we are told that Kanta Buasa, who is a widowed niece of Bhagwat Singh Ji, is to arrive in the Haveli. Then, immediately after this news, there is a banging sound at the main gate of the Haveli and she arrives. Maid servants, they rush in order to collect her luggage. They bring the luggage in and then Kanta Buasa is welcomed by the mistress of the Haveli, that is wife to Bhagwat Singh Ji, called as Kamarni Sa. She is received with proper formality and dignity. Then she sits with the wife of Bhagwat Singh Ji asks her about the condition of her mother-in-law. Then Kanta Buasa tells that her mother-in-law is quite old. She is visiting temple most of the time, and whenever she is annoyed, then she says that the entire property and the money that she has, she will give as a donation to one of the trusts run by the temple where she visits, and this way she tries to terrorize Kanta Buasa and wants to keep her under control. Then Bhagwat Singh Ji's wife tells her that good words cost nothing and she should speak in a honeyed voice to her mother-in-law, and mother-in-law should not be displeased. Then the visitor Kanta Buasa asks about Binani Ji, Geeta, and she tells Geeta's mother-in-law that why Geeta is not there around her. Then she says that if Geeta is busy, then she would go to Geeta's room and ask about her whereabouts. So Kanta Buasa goes to Geeta's room and finds that Geeta is reading a book. Then she says that how is the condition of Binni Ji, and if Binni Ji is not free to talk, then she would return and come after some time, because she does not want to disturb her when she is reading. Reading and writing are preferably the activities of educated ladies, and she does not have any such interest, so she tries to go. But Geeta calls her back and she asks about her condition and about her family. Then Kanta Buasa tells that she got widowed when she was quite young, and now she is passing through her early 30s, and she has been married in a poor family, but her father was quite rich and her grandfather was still richer than what his father was, and his father, because of excessive money, developed some of the bad habits which kept on troubling her mother, and her grandfather never spoke about those unwanted activities of the male gentry because he didn't want any criticism from the other Havelis, so he kept mum. But when his grandfather was quite old, one day he called his daughter-in-law, that is Kanta Buasa, and told her that he has a farmhouse and there is a small room in that farmhouse where the buckets and brooms are kept. The room of that farmhouse is small and dark, and in one of the walls there is a golden and silver jewelry coins hidden inside one of the balls, and the packet has been placed in a box, and she may take after his grandfather is no more. Then she keeps mum and tells her mother about this hidden gold, but her mother is also a lady who is quite formal that way, dedicated to her husband, and then she does not disclose this golden treasure till her husband is alive, and one day her husband expires, and then she tells about the golden ornaments to her son, and her son takes it away, and Kanta Buwasa is not given any share in that golden jewelry. So Geeta is all annoyed to listen about it, and then she says that she should struggle because now she is quite poor. She has been married in a poor family, and then the haveli where she has been married is also a small family. Servants are also not there, so that share would help her, and it is Geeta who would struggle for her. But Kanta Buwasa is not ready because customs and trends of the havelis of not giving any share of their parental property is to be maintained. So this way their talk goes on, and suddenly it is the time for Sita to come and Vijaybaisa to come from their schools. The both of the girls, they come, and as soon as they enter the haveli, then maid servants are also around them, and then both of these little girls, they open their illustrated books and then try to remember their lessons which they have learnt in the school. Say for example, A for apple, B for book, and this way they also make a practice of writing those alphabets. Then Kamarnisa is around them, and then maid servants are also around them. The maid servants Parijiji, Dhapu, Ganga made a fuss because it was Geeta who took a decision to send Sita to school, and this way Kamarnisa wants to ask certain questions from Sita about that fuss that was created by the maid servants. So she asks whether Sita was beaten at the school by the teachers, or did the other girls steal her rotis, or did they harm that little girl in any way. Sita says that neither rotis were stolen nor the teachers beat him, and they helped her to learn and remember the lessons. And this way Kamarnisa looks at the other maid servants who had a negative opinion of sending one of their child to schools, and this way when they hear that schools are enjoyed by the little children, then all of the maid servants, they disappear. And then Geeta also talks about the lifestyle of the families, and she says that traditionality is highly deep rooted in the mind of the ladies or maid servants living in the havelis, and if anything goes wrong, then they run to persons like Arjun Bhopas, and they make full use of their ignorance. Persons like Arjun Bhopa are wrong in 91 cases out of 100 cases, and they are duping the maid servants or uneducated ladies, and uneducated ladies also do not understand all about this, and this way Gita tries to warn them and try to change the customs of the Havelis, but it is very difficult for Gita to encounter them and to teach them. Then there is a message that Ajay Singh is back from Delhi to Udaipur and he is about to reach in the Haveli soon. The car halts inside the Haveli. Ajay Singh comes out of it, meets his mother, touches the feet of mother and exchanges some of the informations, and then goes to the room of Gita, and then he tries to have a bath, and as soon as his bath is over, then Gita asks what he had been doing in Delhi for last 10 days. Then Ajay Singh replies that he was busy in Delhi University for some work and didn't go outside the university. And then Gita asks what are his plan in order to go to Delhi to change his profession of teaching rather than teaching over here in Udaipur University. Is there any plan to begin a fresh career as a professor in Delhi University? Then Ajay Singh's face loses its color. He wants to avoid this question, and then he says that there is no use of going to Delhi because there are so many professors like him in Delhi, and if he is here in Udaipur, he has some utility. More so, he has become the head of the physics department, and that is what Gita knew well in advance, because Ajay Singh was not interested to lose the Haveli and also his parents in order to go elsewhere. So Gita says that she knows what Ajay Singh's decisions are, but anyway, she is also resolute to continue with the life in the Haveli, but she thinks that she will register the customs and traditions that have been going on in the Haveli. So she tries to carry on, but it becomes a lot of burden on her because now she is to continue with her struggle. She tries to avoid that tension and depression and tries to have a sleep with full pleasure and comfort, and then she goes to bed. We shall be taking up the next chapter in our next video class. Thank you so much.